Scroll tracking allows you to get a really good idea of how people are using your site, the content that interests them, and what might need improving. It basically shows you how far down a page someone scrolls before they move on. That kind of information can be really helpful when deciding on the kind of content that you want to put on your site, the length of that content, the type of products and services you might want to offer, and also maybe the layout of the pages. In this video, we're going to look at a really quick and easy way we can add scroll tracking to our WordPress site, and then also how we can see that information in Google Analytics. Let's do it. So to get started and add scroll tracking to our WordPress site, what we're going to do is we're going to install a plugin called MonsterInsights. And MonsterInsights is a fantastic WordPress analytics plugin that has a whole host of features, including way more than just a scroll tracking feature. You've got real-time analytics, e-commerce reports, user behavior reports, and much, much more. It is a really fantastic plugin. And it's also a sister company of WP Beginner, so you know you're in really good hands there too. I actually use this plugin a lot on my websites, and it's really fantastic. You've got lots and lots of features that you can use. There is a light version available of MonsterInsights from the WordPress directory, so you can add that to your site and you can take a look at the plugin itself and see if it's something that you want to use. To use the scroll tracking feature, it is a paid for feature, so you're going to need to head to MonsterInsights. That's MonsterInsights.com. The link for that is in the description, and all the other links for this video will be in the description as well. Once you're on the MonsterInsights website, you'll need to create an account. So to do that, all we need to do is click the Get MonsterInsights Now blue button right here. And now that brings us to our pricing page. And there's a couple of different options that you can choose from. The good thing is for this video, scroll tracking is included with the Plus plan right here. And with the Plus plan as well, you get all of these features as well. You get the standard reports, standard trackings, which you can see scroll tracking is just there, and you get growth tools as well. So that's a really fantastic starting point. So once you've decided on which plan suits you and your website and your business, then all you need to do is create an account by clicking the Get Started button. And then once you've created that account, log in and I'll meet you there. Once you've logged into your MonsterInsights account, you'll see this screen, and all you need to do is come over here to view license key details and downloads. Just click on that. That's brought us to the download section, and as you can see your license key over here. If you just click the little clipboard sign right there, that's going to copy it to the clipboard on your computer. And then if you head over here to the download MonsterInsights button, just click that as well and download the plugin to your computer. So once you've downloaded the plugin and copied the license key, log into your WordPress site and I'll meet you there. So once we've logged into our WordPress site, the first thing we need to do is install the MonsterInsights plugin that we just downloaded to our computer. To do that, all we need to do is head over to plugins here on the left hand side, hover over that, and then click on add new. And the next thing we need to do is just come up here to the upload plugin button, click on that. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to click and drag the file that I've just downloaded and drop it here. You can also click the choose file button and choose it from your computer as well. And then just click the install now button to install the plugin. So once that's installed on your WordPress site, you can now click this blue activate button right here to activate the plugin. And then once that's activated, you'll be able to see this welcome screen for MonsterInsights. If you scroll down a little bit, you'll be able to see launch the wizard button right there. Just click on that. We're going to go through this process. So the first step in the wizard is to choose the category that best describes your website. I'm just going to choose a publisher, blog, website, and then just click save and continue. The next thing the wizard's going to ask you is to paste in a license key you've just copied from your account page over at MonsterInsights. So just paste that in there. That then verifies the license for you. Once that license being verified, you see that little green tick there. And the next thing we're going to do is connect MonsterInsights to Google Analytics. Now, if you haven't set up Google Analytics with your WordPress site just yet, here's a link to a video that will help you out and get you set up. I'm going to carry on and click the Connect MonsterInsights button here. So now you just need to choose the Google account that you use to connect Google Analytics to your WordPress site. So then all you need to do is just confirm that you're going to allow this access. So just click that. Next thing it's asking you to do is to choose the website that you set up on Google Analytics for your WordPress site. So I'm going to choose the Textor one right there. Can click the drop down right here if you've got multiple sites on your Google Analytics account. Then I'm just going to click the blue complete connection button right here, and that's now going to finalize the authentication for Google Analytics and MonsterInsights. And now we're on the recommended settings page for MonsterInsights. So right here we can see the settings that MonsterInsights recommends you have turned on to give you the best possible outcomes. If we scroll down just a little bit, we can see we've got events tracking, which is on, enhanced link attribution, which is on, We're also file download tracking as well. We've got affiliate link tracking right here as well there. And then we've got an option to say who can see reports. So at the moment we've got administrators and editors that can see reports, but we can just have the administrator if you wanted to. We can also check whether we want to install all updates automatically and whether we want to show the MonsterInsights badge. I'm just gonna click save and continue. Now MonsterInsights is asking you what features you'd like to enable on your WordPress site. So we've got standard analytics and reports, enhanced link attribution, all-in-one SEO toolkit. So MonsterInsights will also install all-in-one SEO, and they work together in harmony to give you the best possible data to work from. Also got some conversion tools that we can have, and then there's the list carries on further on down. So if you want to add some privacy compliance, you can do that. Advanced reporting, I'll do that. E-commerce tracking, so I want to track that as well. The 20 advanced tracking features, role tracking is in there, so we want to click on that. And then you've got options to use some of the advanced growth tools and media tracking if you've got videos on your website. So once you've chosen the features that you want on your site, just click the continue button right here, and then MonsterInsights is going to set all that up for us. So once that's all done, we get this message to let us know that all the tracking and analytics that we chose are set up. So we can now scroll down, we can look through this list as well just to make sure everything's on. And then we can click on finish setup and exit wizard. So now that's all set up, as you can see, you get a little congratulations message right here. And the first thing it asks you to do is view your reports. So I'm going to click this blue button here and take a look at the reports. And as we can see a flat line right here for my analytics. And that's because this is a brand new website. I've only just set up Google Analytics on this site. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to send some traffic to the site, and then we're going to take a look how we can view the data and look at scroll tracking in MonsterInsights and then on Google Analytics as well. So now we're back on the WordPress dashboard, and as you can see over here, we've had a few sessions on the website, so we've sent some traffic to the site to trigger some of that scroll depth tracking as well, so that we can see that through MonsterInsights. So to view all this information, all we need to do is come over to here to MonsterInsights on the left-hand side of the page, and then click on Insights. As you can see on the overview over here, lots of information about the data that's being collected and the kind of visitors that we've had to the site. Obviously, some of this information as well isn't as full as you might have on your site, because this is a brand new site, it's a demo site, and I've only had a few sessions on the site to trigger the information needed for this video. So to see scroll depth tracking through MonsterInsights, all we need to do is come up to the tabs over here and just click on Publishers. Now on the Publishers screen, we can see the top landing pages for our site. And then if we scroll down a little bit, we can see at the bottom here, we've got the scroll depth tracking percentage right there. So that's on average how far people are scrolling on our pages on our website. And as you can see right here, there's a little note to let us know that scroll depth events are triggered at 25, 50, 75 and 100% of the scrolling. So that gives us a really good idea of how far people are coming down the page, and then that can inform decisions about like design, layout and things like that, and what people are interested about. So MonsterInsights does a fantastic job of giving us the average scroll depth, but we can also view this information in Google Analytics as well. So all we need to do is head to Google Analytics. So that's analytics.google.com. And then when you're on your Google Analytics, just make sure you're on the site that you want to view the analytics for. Now I'm using Google Analytics 4 for this. If you're using Universal Analytics, then we've got a fantastic article that breaks it down for each Google Analytics and Universal Analytics, and I've linked that in the description below. So from this screen here, how do we see our scroll tracking data? Well, all we need to do is head over to the left-hand side here and click on Reports. And this is going to give us our report snapshot for our analytics data from our WordPress site. And then all we need to do from here is go to Engagement, click on that, and then Events. That opens up all the events that we're tracking on our website. And as you can see right here at the top, there's scroll depth. All we need to do to see the data for the scroll depth tracking is just click on this. So on this screen here, we're seeing all the data collected for scroll depth tracking. So we've got our event counts right here. And then if we scroll down a little bit, we can see the percentage for our scroll depth tracking and also the scroll timing as well. So you can get all this information on Google Analytics, but MonsterInsights does a fantastic job of just simplifying it and giving you that average scroll depth tracking, which is essentially what you need just to be more informed about how people are using your site. I really hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, let us know in the comments below, and also drop any questions down there too, and we'll try and answer as many as possible. If you like this kind of content, then make sure you subscribe to the WP Beginner YouTube channel, because there's plenty more videos on there to help you out with your WordPress site. Thanks for watching.